We have received the message, we have taken the message to heart. By not coming out in large numbers, people were sending a message to us.
Gauteng is now proven to be certainly a province that is up for grabs in very real terms, with both the ANC and the DA very likely to remain under 40% by the end of all of this.
We haven't done enough work to convince people that we are deeply, deeply committed to rebuilding, dealing decisively with corruption. People looked at these issues weak, but we need to do all these things with greater urgency, rebuilding the ANC, making sure that everyone who represents the ANC portrays its image of an organization with integrity.
I think the ANC finds itself in a very peculiar position this time that it hasn't been in before. In the 2016 elections, yes, it needed to deal with coalitions, but certainly it had much more of an advantage in most places than it does right now. I think the ANC always saw itself as kind of the big fish in the coalition game that can dictate terms as it wills. And I think things are different for the ANC now.
For us, it's the low voter turnout. The low voter turnout affected our overall performance. So the majority stayed at home because they want to see more action from the ANC. They want to see more evidence.
But they actually do have a bigger problem than coalition politics. They have a problem of voter participation, their party more than any other in this election. And one would hope that the ANC sees this as an opportunity to really, you know, pull up their socks, to use a very colloquial term, and focus on the business of governing rather than the business of politics. And so all of that leads us to say that 2024 is going to be the most important election of this democracy. And it is wide open for smaller players, for new entrants into the space, and for voters who are now saying very loudly that they're dissatisfied to have the upper hand and ask for what they want.